Alright gang, today we're going to be doing a bit of a 2v2, but this time it is Indy Pride, Turin, Italian Spartacus, and Black Iron Battles in a grand chaos civil war, or seemingly something of the sort. We have Khorne and Nurgle on my side. I'm allied with Turin here against Indy Pride playing Slaanesh and Black Iron Battles. I'm sorry, Gobbo King actually. Gobbo King playing as the mighty Tzeentch, the Exalted Lord of Change. We're using the Ultimate Chaos mod, so there's a little bit of some fun flavored units here. A lot of stuff themed along the lines of Khorne. We have some beautiful Followers of Slaughter, which are your basic kind of like infantry fodder. We've got some Bloodletters in the back, but then we also have the Big Daddy himself, the Bloodthirster of Khorne. We also have some... Really cool thing is here, the Warriors of Khorne, very similar to the tabletop. You can use them with additional weapons here in this case. So these Warriors of Khorne are dual-wielding axes, kind of chopping towards the enemy. And we have a Chaos Lord of Khorne as well. Look at that glorious little axe there. And all beautiful. I played Khorne in tabletop, so I have a little special place in my heart for me. We also have some... More Warriors of Khorne. There they are. The Skull Takers of Khorne, which are these great weapons, great weapon wielding warriors. And we also have some Knights of Khorne as well as just the standard Swords of Chaos. Turin's got a big battery here of plague cannons, kind of already kind of going off on our opponent across the field, and some cultists that are mounted. Really, the pride and joy of Turin's army is boom. The Great Unclean One, with his Champion of Nurgle. And this is a lot of the same stuff we've already seen from the Ultimate Chaos mod, but they did release two other mods in addition, a texture pack, a unit pack, and I believe just the mod itself, kind of like the overcompassing thing. You need all three to play, and it's a beautiful mod. They did a really good job kind of creating all the essence of the other gods that you see in the game that you don't get to really play. So this really gives you a really good chance to see that. But with Indy Pride's army, tons of Slaanesh Chaos, over here, some cultists, some Warriors of Slaanesh here, the backline of Slaanesh is blessed, all up in this line. And he did do some balancing with the Norska release, so a lot of these guys are balanced for the current meta. But he's got some Demonettes of Slaanesh, which are, while not the conventional Demonettes, they'll do the job. Also got these great, awesome Knights of Slaanesh here and here, but he's also then got the Riders of Slaanesh, these Throwing Spears. These guys are beasts. Take a look at these stat lines. So they might not look that impressive, but they are very fast, and since they're armor piercing, these guys can just take down units so fast, and they're pretty quick on their toes. So Indy Pride went with a lot of cavalry, and that's really going to help him out, as you'll learn to see. But he's also got a Slaanesh Sorceress and a Prince Sigvald on a mount, which is unique of course to this mod. And then for Gobbo King, he has a lovely unit of, a lovely Exalted Lord of Change. Can't forsake Big Bird. But as we've seen from Tzeentch, their units do quite a bit of damage, especially their lords. But these guys, I mean, they're silver chevrons, their silver shields, their 100 armor. They do magic and the flaming attacks. And they're quite powerful on their own. But as you can see, Gobble King's already shot off from his lord, that lance. Wait for it to make contact. Oh, boom, right through the Bloodthirster of Khorne there, knocking a pretty chunk of health out there. But also has some Bringers of Change, as well as these Pink Horrors, and you'll see what these Pink Horrors do pretty soon. I don't want to spoil that. And then some Knights of Tzeentch as well. I believe he's brought his respective Tzeentch Sorcerer. Let's go ahead and press play and see how this unfolds. I'm going to take kind of a higher stance here. It's a little bit hard to navigate this, but you can see where my units kind of had kind of a wonky engagement, right? Indy Pride had really gotten a really good drop on this cavalry engagement. So it's going to make it a lot harder for me to push him on this flank I had planned. My units being the Swords of Chaos, which are very strong, and one unit of Knights of Khorne are not going to stack up against these Riders of Slaanesh, which are AP, and the two units of Knights of Slaanesh as well. But, oh, missiles going off already from that Tzeentch as well. Like I was saying, they just shoot non-stop from that Lord of Change. Lying across the way, trying to engage. got the Warriors of Nurgle. Got these Plague Bearers of Nurgle going in as well. Oh, there it is. Go slow-mo on that shit. But yeah, there's those Pink Horrors just going to town, shooting their flamethrower jets all over the place. You're going to see this is a repeating motif throughout this battle. Putting the followers of Slaughter against the Warriors of Siege won't be very fun. And then we also have some Sinesh Blessed against some followers of Slaughter as well, with also some Warriors of Siege in there as well. So it's a very interesting engagement across the line. I didn't really get the best movement, but you can definitely see that Turn has a much better engagement across this one. Oh yeah, bring those juicy flames to me. Oh yeah, look at that. They might not do a ton of damage right off the gate, but they can just constant stream of flames here. You can see that they're constantly pouring it on. You see that the break in chain there means they've just basically shot again and again and again and again. Let's take a look at their unit card real quick. The Pink Horrors, of course, magic and flaming attacks. Quite a bit of ammo. Missile damage 205 from these little guys. So innate spellcasters. I haven't looked at the actual units themselves, so they probably have some spellcasting abilities. Looks like they've got the... they don't have Endless Frenzy. There's an ability over here that I can't see. I think it's for the Dark Magic or Zinch Magic constant thing that's always in effect. Which you'll see them as they play out more throughout the battle. As you can see, the Calvin engagement going pretty wonky on this end of the field. The Plague Bearers, the Plague Cannons, though, still shooting off. They don't do a ton of damage, but they, 252 from cannons is not awesome, but there's so many of them. But Indy Pride silences these quite quickly. Riders of Slaanesh, even though they are missile cav, they still do a ton of damage in melee. Really, really the showcase of this fight, for me at least, is the Bloodthirster of Khorne going after Big Bird, knocking him all sorts of around. Oh yeah, just being covered in flame. Doesn't give any shits. Covered in Bringers of Zinj, covered in Knights of Zinj. Everyone's going for the mighty Bloodthirster of Khorne. You can see Turin got some backline charges over here with these Warhounds. Turin being the consummate strategist bastard. Comes back from Poland, plays the game like he's never stopped. And these Riders of Zinj, unfortunately, are struggling to really pluck into my units. Bloodletters of Khorne are strong and whatnot with their aid, their anti-infantry, their damage dealer, their Endless Frenzy, but they're not going to be able to stand the chance here much against the combined missile cav and the constant conflict going on there. But as you can see, the Bloodthirster of Khorne does not fear battle. I just love that. Look at that. Look how awesome that is. Damn right, I took a fucking screenshot of that. But the real target for... And you can see also the... That B button's annoying. You can also see this... Great Unclean One is having his way with Zinj. Zinj and Nurgle, we know, are kind of arch nemesis, as well as Khorne and Slaanesh. So we know that this is kind of a pretty ideal matchup. Khorne and Nurgle don't necessarily get along, but they do kind of see eye and eye for a lot of things. And Zinj and Slaanesh also, while not getting along 100%, I would say, if anything, a lot of people don't like Slaanesh the most, but still. It makes for a good combat. Bloodthirster of Khorne has chosen his target yet again. Look at this guy, just... Linebacker mode. Truck stick, truck stick, truck stick. Going right for that Exalted Lord of Change. For me, the most part, my army has been in pretty much in tatters. A lot of poor engagements. Khorne as a whole is not very impressive in this mod. He really relies on more units than just strictly Khorne to survive. Oh yeah, just jump kick that Big Bird right in the back. Take that. Learn your ABCs, motherfucker. Little tiny, what are these guys, little dryad models? I really like what they did. They're really creative with their models. Gabo King bringing anything he can to bear. Trying to slow down the mighty bloodthirster. Grit Unclean One wading through combat, still at full health. Need I remind you guys. His regeneration is very impressive, as you'll come to see soon. My units, for the most part, have been completely routed. There wasn't a lot of great engagement with them, so I didn't focus on them a whole lot. The real coup de grace is right there. Right there. Go for it. Do it, Bloodthirster. You know your target. You know what you must do. Juke move. Coming all around. Truck stick. And the ultimate fullback goes for the kill. Sort of. Very slow motion. Boom. Take that, big bird. Your days of tyranny in the Sesame Street have come to an end. Oscar the Grouch is free. And now he's got a new target. Princess Sigvald. Indie Pride, though, has just worked a lot of our entire army with his combined cav. I mean, his Knights of Slaanesh, for the most part, are doing pretty well. I mean, yeah, these guys are knocked down a little bit, but he still has two full units of Riders of Slaanesh in the background here. Sigvald and his Slaanesh Sorcerer are very strong. He's very much still in this fight. A lot of Turin's army has been put to the blade, though, unfortunately. The Warriors of Tzeentch square enough against some Nurgle Warriors, but not a lot to do a ton. The Tzeentch Sorcerer is being occupied, but has now freed himself up of the both Nurgle Afflicted and Chaos Warhounds of Poison. The Great Unclean One, though, is quite unclean. I didn't follow it, but my Bloodthirster did die. It was a pretty unceremonious death as he got surrounded and beat down. You got the flames of Tzeentch just pouring on him. I really hope that in the third game we get to see some actual official Tzeentch units, because in the tabletop this is supposed to be like pink and blue flames from these horrors that's coming out. Very like colorful or multichromatic kind of twisted, weird flames that don't—they almost look almost like electricity more so than the flames themselves. So it's really cool the way they describe them in the book. Coming at you hot and fast with the Great Unclean One's mighty tongue. Imagine that thing just licking you from navel to lips. Ooh. Now, for the most part, it's just the Great Unclean One. You can see how strong he is by just looking at the balance of power. It eats everything in front of him. And his health isn't budging. That's how ridiculous his regeneration is. Uh-oh, but Princess Sigvald shan't have this. Indie Pride coming in with his relief of Riders of Rohan, trying to turn the tide completely and end the tyranny of the Great Unclean One. His garden is no more. Although he does have a champion of Nurgle in the background there. You can see those fucking guys just tearing up those plague bearers. Coming up to the end here, but there's one little final move that Turin does that's pretty impressive. No, Turin being the macro king of the world. Micro king of the world. Oh, look at that little whirlwind attack. He's so artistic. But it's really now, I mean, still, again, look at the balance of power. It's still, oh, look at that explosion of doom there. It's still just the Great Unclean One. That's all that's left. And finally, begins to succumb. The ultimate crumbling begins. But, I mean, that did such a huge chunk of damage. The only thing that was really unscathed by that was Sigvald himself. I mean, look, if he had come through that a little bit better health, whoo, a valiant defeat indeed, as the forces of Tzeentch and Slaanesh beat out the forces of Khorne and Nurgle. And as you can kind of see with my army, the Bloodletters didn't do a whole ton of damage. The Swords of Chaos were just, they were put out of their misery so quick, as well as the Knights of Khorne. Just wasted points right there. The Bloodthirster of Khorne did his job in taking out Big Bird, though, so I'll say it was definitely worth it. But the Warriors of Khorne and Skulltakers of Khorne didn't do a ton of damage. One warrior unit did more so than the rest. And I'll actually bring up Indie Pride's army. But you can see Indie Pride had 4 units of Riders of Slaanesh, 64, 65, and 37 kills respectively. 87 out of his Demonettes of Slaanesh. And then, where are his knights? There, 2 of these knights here, 88 and 95. So they were riding through the lands, delivering a whomping of the asses. And then his warriors were doing quite a bit of damage. 103, well, 24 and 20, but then 72 again. So Indie Pride's army was really, really well composed for this fight. Gobble King and Turin, though, on the other hand, Turin's, of course, his Nurgle's Afflicted are just meant to tar pit. They're just meant to get you in combat and not really do much. But, oh, what is that big-ass star there? The Plague Cannon Battery still got 69 kills on what was probably some pretty substantial units. I didn't see much fodder in Indie Pride and Gobble King's armies. So, it's pretty awesome to see that. Then again, though, the Plague Reapers of Nurgle are very strong with 40, 56, and 36 kills. The Great Unclean One, though, has a whopping 98. Ooh. The Warriors of Tzeentch, though, always a really strong choice. I really like them. As far as the Warriors go, of all 4 of these gods, the Warriors of Tzeentch, I think, are the best. Flaming attacks, they've got that silver armor, they're just beasts. 93, 59, 27, 140, fucking 3. The Pink Horrors weren't overly impressive, but they were spending most of their time fighting the Bloodthirster, so I think a lot of their attention got diverted. But I really enjoy this mod, guys. I really think if you want a really good way of playing what a Chaos Army would be like in maybe the 3rd game, the Ultimate Chaos mod, I couldn't recommend it enough. Hopefully you got a really good idea of how this works here. I mean, we've done this before with some of the other things, but go check out Turin's channel, Gobble King's channel, and Indie Pride. I'll have a link to their channels at the end of this video. But thanks for watching here today, guys. Have a good one and take care.